I'll show you some of the photographs and some of the work we do, and then as the conversation goes ahead, I'll share with you a few of my insights, which of course you're free to dismiss, because that would mean that you have some ideas of your own. So I lead a firm in Delhi called Knots and Crosses, and I'm sure everybody here has played this game, sitting at the back of the class sometime or the other. These are a couple of books that we've done. So this is what we get paid for, shooting buildings most of the time. So we travel all over Southeast Asia, covering architecture mainly. So in everything that I'm showing you, you need to understand, as I'll go on through the talk, there's a lot of love in everything. I absolutely love architecture and construction, because growing up as a child, I saw a lot of it. Can't leave this one out. Huh? Bragging moment when the Prime Minister and the President release your book. There's a lot of wildlife in what we do. So hopefully no one's yawning yet. So for me, photography, when I started back in college, it was 1999, it was on a borrowed camera. Somebody else paid for the film. Somebody else paid for printing. I came from a family that only had a hot shot. I don't know if anybody knows what a hot shot even is. It was a small box camera, and I was never allowed to touch it. Photography was something like a Ferrari. You look at it. You lust after it, but you never think of owning it. Because you know, bade log ke liye, you know, you never thought about photography. Back in those days, I used to cover wildlife from my childhood, stayed on with me, and a lot of social work. And since I was living in the university, covered the college building and whatever was around. Never really traveled very far because, again, it required money. After college, I was very lucky. I got to travel the world, saw the carving of a glacier, and that pillar of ice that you see falling into the ocean is about 25, 30 stories high. That's how huge it is. I learned that fish can fly. And when fish fly, then birds fly after them and, you know, sometimes end up eating them. That's, if you want to call it my office, that's what my workplace looks like most of the time. But I completely enjoy it. And then there are those days when the summer heat gets to you and one forgets that your last name is Fanthome and you think that you're Batman or some other superhero, but life goes on. Photography has allowed me to get close to a lot of things and see a lot. This love story has really expanded the whole world for me. That's me with a silkworm, that's me with fried silkworms, and that's me eating silkworms. They're not very tasty. They're not tasty at all. What are tasty are carpenter worms, bamboo worms, grasshoppers, and wasp larvae, all of which I thoroughly enjoy. Photography has also helped me learn how to handle snakes through my work. And sometimes things don't go so well. You get bitten. But that's life. You go on. That's me working very hard. I'm at work. This is not a vacation. That's what work looks like for us. So everything started with this love story between two people, my parents, who were absolutely in love with the idea of teaching. They ended up going to a very remote village in Eastern Bhutan. And like Vikas was telling you, we never saw cars. I mean, if a car came into the village, the idea was, who touched the car? We didn't talk about riding a car or sitting in the car. The idea was, oh, I touched the car yesterday. And you were the hero the next day in class, as we, you know, sat in, on the floor, bare feet. Their love for teaching and what my father used to tell me was that when you get into something, you know, you just have to get in all the way, otherwise don't get into it. And with photography, that's something that happened. My love for architecture that I was talking to you about started with this place. This was a tiny village when I was growing up. And as you can see, this entire college campus that was built as I grew up. It was built around us. And so I fell in love with all the JCBs and the road rollers and the millers, like all small kids do. And I just you know, never grew up. I'm still in love with them, still love working with them. That's my class one photograph in the Kanglung Primary School, the government school. And the most good looking one, of course, that's me. So I had the most exquisite childhood. Yeah, I can't thank my parents enough. I don't know, people have had pets here, parrots, dogs. I had all of those, and I had barking deer, and I don't know how many different types of animals at home. And this love for wildlife, construction, and machinery carries with me even to this day. So I'm not doing anything very different. So when I say I haven't grown up, I really haven't. That love then is still here with me. Photography is just a medium that helps me, you know, live that love story today. And that's why, speak to any one of my friends or my family, they'll tell you I'm the most impatient person. But I'll sit in one place for 4 hours without moving, without answering nature's call, hardly breathing, taking one photograph after the other so the snakes don't get scared, go from 1, 2, 3, 4 and back to 3 till I get what I'm finally looking for. When you're in love, all this becomes very easy. You forget the rugged rock you're sitting on, you forget water, you forget the sun, you forget everything. You're in love. And you keep on and on and on and on till you're there. This hawk moth out here, since childhood I was in love with it. I thought it was a hummingbird. Of course, we don't have hummingbirds in this part of the world, but for us it was a hummingbird. To take a photograph of a moth that never sits was absolutely difficult. I mean, no autofocus works, nothing works, and you go on and on and on. But when you're in love, it's fun. You go on and on and on till you get something like this. It's a very interesting photograph for me. Not only do I like the visual, we joke around in office calling it the Susu shot. And the reason why we call it the Susu shot is because I stopped the car while we were driving around in Bundelkhand on work to take a leak. And then I went down, and then I came up, picked the camera, took the photograph, and we drove off, and I forgot why we had stopped the car. Because I saw something like this just when I went down, and everything else faded away. Nature's call, the pressure, stopping the car, work, nothing mattered. All that mattered was what I was seeing and the pleasure that I was getting. And all that mattered to me at that moment was, could I take this and share this with other people? That was it. When you're in love, cliched as it might sound, it's very easy to go down on your knee. And when you do go down on your knee, these mirrors that you see sold around on tailors, in market fairs, in the villages, normally if you're standing straight, they'll show your paunch, if you're fat like me. But if you go down on your knee, what do you end up seeing? Something quite gorgeous, something quite splendid. All you need to do is bow down. And when you're in love, that becomes very, very easy. Here's another thing. You know, there's another cliche, what beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder, right? So we were out with my niece Zara and my good friend Varun, who's a great wildlife photographer. We had gone to take her to the Delhi Zoo. She wanted to see the big teeth of the crocodile. So there was Varun holding up his daughter, looking at the crocodiles. But what was I looking at? I was looking at a drain. But in that drain, I could see something like this. Because for me, it didn't matter that it was a drain filled with algae, stinking, none of that mattered. I was just interested in the visual. That's all I could see. Something beautiful, and I took a photograph. And now it hangs in a couple of drawing rooms. I'm quite happy. Here's another photograph. Once again, when you're in love, you don't know what controls you. You don't know how things are happening around you. I can't tell you I was very good at maths with those, you know, A is traveling at this speed, B is traveling at that speed. They're going to meet at some point. None of that mumbo jumbo. Not at all. But when I saw these people walking from the left, these two men, and I saw those women walking out there, I don't know what, you know, you can't explain what takes over. It's like a junoon that we say in Hindi. Na? Something takes control of the camera, takes control of you, and you end up taking the photograph. And then after you take the photograph, you're wondering, just how did I do that? And the only explanation that I have ever been able to find for any of these photographs that I end up taking, and I keep scratching my head, figuring out, you know, how did I do it so that I can do it again and become a rock star? I just never have an explanation. And there are moments like this, when you're in Rashtrapati Bhavan photographing the president, and the photograph stuck up in Rashtrapati Bhavan for eons to come, and you're very proud, I can tell all of you that. But what photography also allows you is, while you're flying so high, you can keep your feet right down on the ground. And the next moment, you'll be with these women from SAGs and RGMVP in rural UP, transforming their lives, and you're just as happy. You're just as content. These next two photographs are very, very important to me, especially this one. This one's called Same. In photography, you know, one of the biggest criticisms of photography is that photography freezes the moment, captures the moment. But unlike a film or anything else, any other form of art, it cannot show you the passage of time. It's just that one split second, gone, finished, done. This particular photograph, for me, was a big achievement. Because as a photographer, if you look at these shadows, you'll see how on one side they're here, on the other side they're on the left. From right to left, the shadows move because the way the sun moves. And that's why I call it Same. It's basically the passing of a day. But what this photograph cannot explain to you is at that point of time, I had my right hand, my left hand, and my right leg. This leg was asleep. I had a very, very bad slip disc. I could barely move it, no toe movement, nothing. It used to just hang out there, and my mean friend sometimes used to call me a tripod. And as a photographer, somebody who can't move around, you know, it gets very, very difficult to deal with that agony. So there I was standing, you know, shouldn't say standing, sitting in the balcony, looking out of the window. And the only place where I could see activity or any form of, you know, things happening was outside this window in this park. And this happened, this took many days to come about. It wasn't that I went in there like a genius and saw it and said, oh wow, I'm going to make this photograph. It doesn't work like that. I went out, saw it a couple of times, then saw it again, then saw it again, and then finally it came to me, not while I was looking, but far away, that if one was to capture these two photographs, you could actually, show the passing of a day. And the actual photograph takes like what, 1 minute? Like most people say, karna kya hai? Batni to dabana hai. So yeah, the taking of the photograph barely takes any time, but it's the thinking behind it. And the reason why I always show this photograph to anybody is, you know, there are lots of times when we think that everything's coming crashing down on us and everything's breaking up. At the time that I was most handicapped to take a photograph, most handicapped, I couldn't even get out of my flat, was the time that I have taken the photograph I'm most proud of and happiest about. A time when I had only one leg that was functioning and the other leg was just hanging. So don't lose hope, stay in love, and you'll get to see stuff like this. You'll be able to do stuff like this. The next photograph is the photograph that got me the National Academy Award. Now here too, I was walking in Chandni Chowk on assignment, and the footpath became very busy. I had one camera, and I was very possessive about it. No money again, so didn't want anybody bashing into it. And so I stepped onto the road to save my camera from all the elbows, all the pushing, all the hugging. And I barely walked two steps when I suddenly saw this visual. And just like, you know, one of those special forces army guys, I turned around, took out my camera, turned back and took the photograph. That's exactly what happened that day. I got two shots and the guy turned and said, "Bhaiya, kya kar rahe ho?" And then I showed him the photograph, not knowing that it would get me the National Academy Award or anything. But here too, what I'm trying to tell you is this. And this would be my most important message to you. You know, when you're in love and you really want something, there's a world, this whole universe makes it happen. I grew up in a home without really a camera. I didn't have money for film. I didn't have money for printing. The first photography competition I entered in my good friend Sneha's name, not in my name. I was so ashamed. I was so unsure of myself. She won a prize and told me, so the next competition I entered in my name. And so on the story went. My teachers gifted me cameras. All along, even the job that I got that helped me travel around the world, somebody else found out about it and sent it to me as a joke. Every step of the way, there were people who were helping me around. The problem was I never really looked at all of this happening, and I was always too busy, you know, complaining and wondering about my leg, wondering about that, wondering about the other. But if you really take stock of your life and you look at what you have, you'll realize that you know, it's all there. But if you want to sit and complain, then you won't end up taking a photograph. You'll just worry about your leg and you'll stay in bed. gets you nowhere. So fall in love with whatever you do. You'll not feel the burden of waiting for hours. You'll not feel the pokey stone that you're sitting on. You'll not think about the call of nature. You'll remember nothing when you're in love. Be in love with what you do and everything will find a way. Thank you.